Okay, we need a diversion.
Epiphany doesn't do diversions.
What if we created some crisis at the hospital that only Epiphany could
solve? She runs that place so well, even when she's not there, she's so organized.
Right. What if I sent her out for some weird craving of mine? Something rare and healthy, or something really good like barbecue calamari?
Hey, focus. First of all, Epiphany probably knows somebody that grills squid for a living. Second of all, she would get suspicious. Now, okay, what if we did something with this whole medication scare at the hospital? You know when she gave Nicholas the drugs for his seizure and they didn't work?
That investigation is closed.
I know, but what if we ask her to look back into it? Like, people are getting contacted and she needs to look over the records and stuff.
That's really good, because then she would love to show up Dr. Ford because of something that he missed.
Okay, perfect.
You didn't lock the door.
My mistake.
I'm calling the police commissioner.
No, you know what? I didn't come here to see Robin. Epiphany. I came here to see you.
Her and I make a good team.
This food is so good.
It's really good.
You better enjoy this, kiddo, because once you get here, we're going to eat very healthy.
That's too bad. How long do you think Epiphany will be gone for?
A while, I hope. I have to say, though, I feel bad about sending her on a wild goose chase.
Yeah, well, maybe it isn't. You know, maybe she'll review the charts and maybe she'll find something that somebody else missed. Maybe Epiphany will be a hero.
So maybe we did a good thing.
If it buys us some time, yeah, we did a good thing.
Would that be you talking me into having sex?
Okay, Epiphany, I know what you're thinking. Now, there's something you need to understand. See,
this is my apartment. This is my pregnancy. And from now on, I call the shots. I appreciate everything you've done. You're a dedicated and caring nurse.
Exemplary.
Well, that's a lot more than I could say for the patient.
But I didn't ask to be your patient. You know, I didn't hire you. My Uncle Mac did, out of concern and because he's insanely overprotective of me.
But that's no reason to send a health professional on a wild goose chase.
Yeah, you know what? But I did have legitimate concerns about the meds being dispensed at the hospital.
Then you shouldn't have used it as an excuse to get rid of me. Not that I believed you. Either one of you.
I'm sorry. This hasn't been fair to you. I am grateful for everything that you did. But the truth is, I wanted Patrick here all along, and I just don't need anyone else.
I just came to get my suitcases. You know, next time, why don't you have the guts to speak up? You two are about to become parents. And I think it's about time that you start acting like grown-ups.
Epiphany was right.
You're supposed to be avoiding stress, stop beating yourself up about it.
I should have just been upfront about it.
Robin, you didn't hire her. Your overbearing uncle with control issues did.
He can't help it. Mac raised me.
Well, you're not his little girl anymore. He's got to let you go.
Okay, for a moment, just try to imagine, you know, a young man, you know, about your age, player, doesn't really want to settle down. I know it's hard to imagine.
Okay, got it.
Okay, so that was Mac. And then all of a sudden, he had to become my guardian and de facto father. I mean, he wasn't really equipped to deal with a teenager with raging hormones, much less one that had just been diagnosed with HIV. And he was with me every single day, every step of the way, finding me the best doctors, and the whole time blaming himself. I mean, it didn't matter how many times I told him that he couldn't have been a better parent or guardian to me. He still believes that it's his fault that I have HIV. And so, yeah, I mean, he worries a lot, and he's a little overbearing, but I know that it all comes out of love.
Robin, it's Mac. Look, I know Epiphany quit. I better not find Patrick in there.
Don't let him see you.
Robin, what happened about dealing with him like an adult?
Robin!
Hide!
What?
Go! Well, I can't get up off the couch, so you can just come in.
Hi.
Hi.
Look, this is exactly why I hired Epiphany. There's no way you're going to be able to follow doctor's orders and stay off your feet unless you have someone here to help you.
I would like to have someone here helping me, but I would like that someone to be Patrick.
Can we aim a little higher, like a functioning grown-up?
He's a doctor.
He's a frat boy with a medical degree.
Okay, I thought you liked Patrick.
Not since he reacted with sheer terror when he found out you were pregnant.
He just needed time to get used to the idea.
Come on, look, he walks around the hospital like he's God's gift. The guy is not responsible enough to take care of you, much less the baby in the future. You're kidding yourself if you think you can count on Patrick Drake.
You know what, Mac? With all due respect, you're full of crap.
I knew you were hiding here somewhere, which only proves my point. Instead of acting like a responsible father-to-be, you're skulking around like a teenager.
Wait a minute, the skulking was my idea, to avoid a testosterone-filled moment, just like this one. I mean, I'm not supposed to be stressed out, remember?
Right, yes, and that's why you're coming home with me, to get away from the stress.
Okay, you know what, Mac? I get that you're worried about Robin. I get that in your mind, nobody's ever going to be good enough for her. I get that because I may have a daughter, and I could see myself acting almost as crazy as you.
Right, then you listen to me.
No, Mac, you listen to me, okay? I love Robin. I support her in any way that I can. And I'm the father of that baby, and I'm not going to let you run me out of their lives. That's a lot better.
I'm struggling with the idea of being a father right now, Mac. I've been honest about that from the beginning. Maybe too honest. But the one constant through all of this is my love for Robin. I love her more every day. And as far as taking care of her, my heart dropped when I saw her on the floor, and I will never let that happen again. I am committed to her having a healthy pregnancy and giving her all the support she needs. So you know what, Matt? Robin's not going home with you. I'm staying here, and I'm going to take care of her. You're more than welcome to come and visit if you want, but just...
Are you through?
Yeah, I think I am.
Good, then you're under arrest.
Hey!
What are you talking about?
Turn around.
Matt!